experience with cancer. What a year it's been. Just now getting to the point where I can get back on the guitar again. Can't quite sing yet, really. I can barely even talk most days. I've already tuned the guitar, but all I gotta do is just hit this E note right here. Once I got that down, I can use the relationship between the distance and the frequencies. I got all that down. Some people need tuners for all the strings. I just need the first one. So the E, once you got that down, you can match it to the second string. Same sound if you go right there. You gotta go down one for the next one. And back to where you were. One more down. Also, down up here, you see the double. That's one octave higher. This won't go two octaves higher, I don't think. One short. I don't play it very far up there anyway. I do only like two songs I play up in there. It's really hard for me. And I'm usually doing something like the one on Firepower where it goes. The first song I played was an original called Firepower that got turned into something else later. But it was the first one, and it's the one that had the most activity going on that was different from all the other ones. So the rhythm guitar had something entirely different going on than what the lead was doing, and the bass was way, way out there as far as and just all sounds really cool together. So you're not really going to get the full flavor. If you look earlier, I have other videos of Flamingo. Or Firepower, as it was called earlier. But this one I started out writing with what I thought to be at the time like a Chinese or Japanese introduction. So it went like that, and then it went into like they don't even do this anymore, but back in the 70s when I wrote all this stuff, they did, long, extended parts of songs, especially introductions, and I had a lot of long introductions. And anyways, that song was pretty good, and the rhythm part went something like. And then the lead was going. I can't remember where that note was anymore. And during the lead part, the rhythm and the bass and the lead all kind of bounced off of each other. Now, if you do have neighbors, make sure that you're good before you start turning the volume up really loud. My next door neighbor, when we had the windows open in the summer, we could always hear each other. She can sound really good, but I had to explain to her, well, she was born in Japan, and her father was probably listening to my stuff on a Yokohama radio station to inspire her birth, so she owes her existence to me. Yeah, I've been playing guitar longer than she's been alive. The next song I did, it sounded like Lola or something, but it was my second song, named after a girlfriend that I still love to this day. And that was later changed to another girl I met in Japan that was not a girlfriend, but just an inspiration to me. So I changed the words and kind of, but the music was pretty much the same as it was from the beginning in 77. I think it was 78 maybe for this one. It started out with like a Clapton-like thing. That's also how I do my birthday introductions, if you haven't noticed. I'll get it back though, I'm kind of out of tune right now. The guitar is a perfect tune. Once I get that first note, there's two ways I can do it. I get the keyboard out and find out, okay, where's the E, what's it sound like, and I match it up. Or I just go to one of my old YouTube videos, because I already had it matched up for that. I'm like, oh, there's the E. And usually I do it 1/34, you know, the. Show you some things about how I play guitar. I'm not good. I'm really not. At most, I do cheats on it because certain notes up here will match something down here. So I just leave that open. And there's a lot of notes. There's a lot of repetitive chords that I've used that are different than what you're going to see in music classes on how to play a chord, because most of the time they're going to say, yeah, you did that right, John, but always bring your index finger all the way across and then add another one just to bridge it in where you had your. And I just use the shortcuts of an open note as much as I can on almost all of mine, and if I can't, like in the F, what you see is, I always have a frame of reference on where the guitar is based on where I'm filling this right here. So if I'm filling this right here, I know exactly where everything is. So it's over here when I'm doing this part. I normally don't need to look at it very much. But you'll see me doing a lot of looking at it today, just for the heck of it. It doesn't really make any difference. I know where everything is. But even though I kind of sometimes will miss, sometimes you'll see barely glance down to nail it. With the F, I didn't need to. Because I can feel right here where this is different than this fret to my fingers. So I know on the bottom. So as soon as I hit that, I'm like, well, that's the F. And what you see me doing to cheat is I'm skipping these two strings, because if you don't skip them, you're going to play them open and it's not going to be a good match. You can hear it, these two are down out of tune now if I play them. So you'll see, just depending on what chord I'm hitting, I just learn them all that way and just learn how to keep it that way. The D is also a cheat for me. I just use these three because the last three are open, match the D. Just fine. That's not really how you're supposed to do it, but I cheat and it works. So that's where you get the one that had the introduction to the second song I did. See, I'm hitting all six there. And here I'm just going to hit four, because these last two aren't good matches for these. So I just learned with each chord just to hit the top four strings as far as frequency. Low frequency is the E down here. High frequency is the E up here. And the really high frequency is the E higher than that. So you got a three octave range and then some up above that. So what else can I tell you about how I play the guitar that's different? First of all, I have no rhythm at all. I really don't. But I like to play it that way. People who've got used to my songs over time, especially when they hear them live, they're like, yeah, this sounds just like it did on the 92 CD. So they're expecting it to sound, you know, out of, almost, what was it, Scott Joplin's syncopation, I think that's what they call it, where he would intentionally go a little bit like Lou Armstrong would also do. He would intentionally go off the one, two, three, four, Now, I won't say that there's not some guitarists that'll play fifths that really don't exist. I don't get that bad. Some guitarists that get on fifths will play fifths, but not intentionally. Anyway, that's how John learned guitar. So what else do you want to hear? The ending of that second song I really liked a lot. I pretty much kept that in as I originally played it. Well, I originally wrote it for piano, so it was kind of tough to transfer it to guitar, but it works just fine. And what I can do is slide. You can't really do that on the digital keys of a keyboard. I guess they got stuff out now you can. But you can actually slide. I just hit that one open. What I do is I use as much open notes as I can. What else? We had one part in Flamingo, the first song, originally known as Firepower, where it had kind of a cool run in the lead. Let me just remember how that was. Yeah, I was up here. And then on the other guitar, I was down here. And then how did I get there? I have one part that went like. I'm just trying to remember that one. Yeah, that's it. That's what that was. When I get back into, I haven't played this thing for about 6 months. When I get back into it, I'll get better at this. I just wanted to show you some of the shortcuts you're always going to see on my live stuff. I've always done it this way from the beginning. I've never had formal training, so all my stuff is kind of unique in that way. And it's not going to sound like anything else you've ever heard out there for that reason. And there are those songs that I just love, like 134. I can almost dare to sing it, but I'm not going to. Not quite there yet. And then we had the lead. See, I did an open note there, see? Now, real guitarists would actually do something else. They'd be down on these notes to hit the bottom of that, and they'd get up there and just kind of leave it all in the same area. But I just like to slide around on the same string. But I just love the 134. See, that was the open note there. What else could I show you? You guys may have seen my videos that came off of a song called From Here to Eternity. And that one had another interesting introduction. It used the, and it was right after Eddie Van Halen started using that stuff where you could just hit stuff without using this one. He just hits that and all of a sudden it'll pick up and sound like a really cool fast, you know, the heavy metalers do that a lot too. I don't very much, but I did on that song. Doesn't sound very good with this amplifier I have. I normally plug it up to a much louder boxes that have a lot of cool effects and stuff you can add and make it sound really Pink Floyd or Gene Simmons or Ace Frehley or whatever. But I really like that Pink Floyd guitar. I just don't like the music, but I love the guitar. And I think you'd have to almost have a Les Paul to do some of that. If you didn't notice, there are two sets of pickups. One's down here that looks like it's all broken. Probably my guitar's all messed up. And If you hit down here, you'll hit that one. If you hit up here, you hit this one. Hit in the middle. I'm not really sure, but it's either going to be all three or just the one in the middle. But there are five positions. So I guess it's a 1, 2, 3, 4. So there's some variation in there. But there's only two volume controls. Well, it says volume and tone, so this is different than most of my guitars. I'm not really picking up a lot of tone with this amplifier, though. I sure would pick up the I don't use the volume intentionally. I just normally set it and leave it there. There's one song, the 134, where after I come out of the lead, where I just go, and then I use the open notes. And then I turn it off. And then I let it go through a bar, and then when it comes in for the next set, I already have that note hit. You wouldn't hear this the way on little speakers or anything. This is just, you can hear my strings here, but then you'll hear the amplifier come on when I do that. So it just fades in, which is about the only time I ever use that. And what else? That's it. Now you know everything there's to know about John Solomon on guitar. But the song From Here Eternity had that introduction, and then it went into almost something like opera, as far as it was like 10 minutes, 12 minutes long. But it started out, you know, with the first segment went like, that's my favorite cheat note. G, just the open G, that one note, everything else just comes right along. And then it goes. And then it goes into a bridge. And it does like four times. And then after that, it breaks into what you hear on my introductions. And it goes into like almost a chorus thing. And then you can hear, if on the song itself, you can hear the, we'll do this the second time, when you actually hear the part that is the, you know, on the intro I use this here, it's the, from here to eternity, the sun is. So yeah, I'm gonna get my voice back one of these days. But there's just an awful lot of different songs. Most of them are based on what you just seen, just variations of it. The Disaster song, it just uses the same chords as Flamingo, which is why I always played those two together live, one after the other, sometimes in either order. That's just how it is. So, I know about a guitarist. Now you know how not to play guitar. God bless.